About what it means to be single. I personally think you're single until you're in a committed relationship. My friend thinks you're single until you're married. I've been with my kid's father for 5 years. We live together, we share expenses, and a lot of my married friends still consider me to be a single woman. Miss Kim, that's me. What do you think? Am I considered single, or are you technically single until you're married? Since she asked me, I'll talk first. I do not agree with you are single until you're married. If I'm in a committed relationship with you, I've been going with you all this time, we got kids, we ain't even gotta have kids. If I'm committed to you and you're committed to me, I am not single. If I'm not living with you, if I'm in a committed relationship with you and we've been going together all these motherfucking years, you mean to tell me it's okay for me to go on a date with somebody else? It's okay for me to have sex with somebody else? It's okay for me to do these things? I don't think so. Oh. So in my mind, writer, you are single until you're in a committed relationship. I'm sorry.
And I agree. I will have to piggyback off that. I agree with Kim. We live in a time right now where everybody's not going to want to get married. So that means you can't be in a committed relationship because you're not married. Marriage is not a thing that's going to be on the table for everybody. I'm with you. If I decide to commit to this person, I'm committing to this person. Therefore, we're both off the table for other people.
Right.
So that means we're not committed. We're not married, but we're not fucking single no more.
My grandma said you are single until you are married.
But
I feel the same way. If we are not married, we are both single. We can still be in a committed relationship. That doesn't mean that we aren't single. Ain't no box full of shit.
Okay.
Ain't no box. It's no different than being a man or a woman. All these blurred lines is starting to get on my nerves about what you being called. You're single or you're married.
Well, okay.
That doesn't mean nobody. When I say I'm single, it doesn't mean that I'm not in a relationship. It just means I'm single.
But both of you all kept saying I'm in a committed relationship. Commitment is defined differently by whoever the two people who are committing to it are. I mean, for instance, do I have the kind of commitment that if you walk out on me and leave me holding a bag with rent and kids and the rest of this, that our oral commitment allows me to go after you legally for the word that you said is your bond? That is why I feel like marriage is marriage. Do I feel like my commitment is my commitment to you because we've had an oral agreement? Yes. But can I hold it up in a legal court of law where
I'm not going
to that's what commitment means.
Because when you're married, you and that person are responsible for each other.
And I can,
no matter what.
And I'm going to tell you like this, goddammit. Well, I got a ring on my goddamn finger or not. We sure ain't got that ring. Your black ass walk out on me, your monkey ass gonna pay half that goddamn ring until this goddamn lease is up. Whether I go get my brother and he fucking do
it. But I've been there and done that, and people have walked out, and I've been holding the bag because the oral commitment that I have for you is not on paper. There is no legally binding contract between us, and what we agreed upon, even though I'm not no damn idiot, and I absolutely ran numbers and had discussion before, but should have had your bitch ass sign a promissory note. Because without me actually turning it into something where we have signed, we have some kind of contract, my oral commitment don't mean shit. If you a bitch ass,
I get it on those levels, but that's how I look at it. I felt like the reader was asking as far as, you know, like, going out on dates with people, having sex with other people, you know, like that. Like, a lot of times, married women will say,
I don't, yeah, it, will there be consequences if you go out with somebody else? Yes, there will. But if you go out with somebody else and have a great time, until you are committed and married to that person, then you still have an out, and you can still decide to be with someone else.
I've heard, but you can easily pick up and leave your life. I mean, my daddy always told me, mama's baby and daddy's maybe, and I agree. I don't expect that if we've had a long discussion about who we are to each other and what it means, I don't expect you to just act like simply because we're not at the stage of marriage that those commitments don't mean anything. But I feel like I've also been raised to recognize that you may not, in fact, honor that word. If I really expect you, if I really want to hold you to honoring that, then we have to have a commitment that ultimately is either a civil or religious commitment. Otherwise, I need to shore myself up in any other kind of ways, because if no one can hold you to an oral commitment that we made amongst each other, and you can be like, nah, I ain't say that.
Okay, so the moral of the story is, goddamn, we need to get promissory notes. Well, not me,
but
I'm married.
No, but the moral is basically is different strokes for different folks. Exactly. It all depends on what you believe. But if you're speaking from my point of view, I think the writer, you've been living with your baby father for 5 years, y'all have kids. To me, you're not single. You're with him, and you are not single.
And there
well,
is
depends on your state and your common law.
There's a such thing of common law marriage. Yeah.
But that takes almost 10 years.
Seriously, that's
single means by definition.
The law goes by that.
Single means by definition unmarried or not in a stable sexual commitment. If you have a boyfriend, you are not single if you are in a stable commitment.
But what if you just said not a stable sexual relationship? What if you're in a stable sexual relationship?
Then they're saying you're not single.
They're saying, yes.
Right. That's what I'm just saying by definition. You said it.
Sexy black dress. Hey, Keisha.
Hey, baby.
Hey,
yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
But yes, I would have to agree, but bedroom ceremonies do not count. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I mean, there are a lot of things that people will say in the heat of the moment, or because it's cheaper to keep her happy right now, not forever. And so, no, and my only thoughts about this always end up being, because no, if we have an oral commitment and you step out on that, I'm going to be just as pissed off as if we are married. Mm-hmm. But for me, I'm always thinking about it as being a woman. Being a woman, I've got to make sure that I look out for myself and for the well-being of children. The law don't go after these men if they do not sign a birth certificate, if they leave their children at 3 or 4 years. If I don't drop my child off at a safe harbor, I've abandoned them. So I always think about it from my biological responsibility. I could be left not only holding the bag financially, but with a kid. So I need to fully make sure that if we're choosing to move ahead and we don't believe in marriage, if we don't ever really feel like that is an institution that we need to, then we need to have something ironclad about these kids, because if at a point you get pissed off at me about the agreement that we have, you can't shirk your responsibility for these children that we made. And that's what I mean about commitment, because marriage allows me to be able to do that.
But the end of the letter, at the end of the day, the letter, our answer to the lady is whatever floats your boat at this point.
Exactly.
Whatever makes you happy.
Whatever makes you happy at some point, you have to be smart about the decisions that you make.
Yes.
I have a friend who has a baby by her guy. They've been together for a little over a year now. It may even be close to 2 years, but maybe like a year and a half or so. Anyway, had the baby by the guy, and she just now found out that he only makes $30,000. He don't have no license.
She had met with somebody.
I'm going back, remembering the courting of this whole situation and everything. So I remember how she was going out with him, and it was all fun times, all good times. You know, one thing leads to another. The head follows, or the heart follows sometimes before the brain does, whatever. And she literally said to me, her words was, "I didn't know he was a bum. That's my fault. I need to do my research. I didn't." And you know, she just turned like 30. So
well, she still ain't single until she break up with.
I didn't talk about the single part, but I'm just talking about going to just make a smart decision.
Like, well, you know, do your due diligence.
Well,
do your investigation.
Oh, look, I'm all trying to like, well,
investigate hoes.
To the reader.
You heard that?
I think the final synopsis of this whole thing is technically on paper, no. Yeah. You have to circle that single box because you're not married.
Uh-huh.
But in real life, Some people think differently, but for me, since you asked me, I think you are definitely not single as long as you're in a committed relationship with somebody. Go out on a date with somebody, see when he come find you and choke your ass.